Hey guys, welcome to our channel, Chill on You Too. Space travel has traditionally been a government-led activity, and it's never been cheaper. Becoming a NASA astronaut is far harder than getting into Harvard. It's good that the stratospheric cost of putting people and payloads into space is finally starting to fall due to the rise of SpaceX and other private space travel companies. The mega-rich will be able to buy a rocket ride into orbit. NASA plans to open International Space Station to commercial business, including tourism, although the tickets won't be cheap. Here's a look at what it costs to go into space, whether it's another satellite that needs to be placed into orbit, or an adventurous billionaire looking for a joyride around the moon. So let's get started. Virgin Galactic. Virgin Galactic launched their first trip to near space on December 13, 2018. Two pilots, Mark Stucky and Frederick Sturckow, took Virgin's spaceplane VSS Unity to an altitude of 82.7 kilometers. This year, the company plans to conduct more test flights with this goal in mind: average regular people traveling to space. Six passengers on each flight will experience several minutes of weightlessness and be afforded the incredible views of Earth as the spaceplane hops into space before returning to a runway landing. Though space tourism is Virgin Galactic's ultimate focus, the company has expressed interest in expanding its capabilities. Virgin Galactic founder Richard Branson has talked about eventually developing point-to-point travel, which entails rocket-powered vehicles taking passengers from one point on Earth to another. Point-to-point travel has been floated around by other companies too, notably SpaceX, but such technology is far from reality. What's the cost? More than 700 people have bought tickets on the Virgin Galactic at a cost between $200,000 and $250,000. I think if you want to feel weightlessness, a skinny margarita is a lot more affordable. NASA. NASA is opening the International Space Station, ISS, to adventurous tourists. And those interested don't need to hold their breath because space tourism could happen as soon as 2020. Since NASA mothballed its space shuttles in 2011, NASA has relied on the Russian Soyuz spacecraft to get astronauts on the ISS. The ISS will be open to not only tourists, but also commercial ventures. That means that product testing, private research, and even filming from outer space movies could take place aboard the station. Yeah, the next Apollo movie could actually be filmed in space. NASA hopes to end its reliance on Russia in 2019, when SpaceX's Crew Dragon and Boeing Starliner capsules begin taxi flights to the ISS. Elon Musk said that the SpaceX lunar trip would brush past the surface of the moon and venture deeper into space before looping back to Earth. SpaceX and Boeing are both under contract with NASA to take astronauts to and from the International Space Station. The first crewed mission for both these companies are set to take place in 2020. The ISS itself could be open to tourists starting this year. NASA said it would cost $35,000 a night for stays on the ISS, and the price to get there is estimated to be $50 million. Blue Origin. Blue Origin will launch its first rocket for space tourism in 7 months. Jeff Bezos' company Blue Origin has successfully launched its New Shepard vehicle for the 12th time as it continues its efforts to offer people short jumps into space. The vehicle rose 106 kilometers into the sky and pierced the boundary of the upper atmosphere that is considered the beginning of space. Blue Origin is also developing an orbital rocket called New Glenn. Jeff Bezos' rocket company Blue Origin is planning something similar, sending space tourists on its New Shepard rocket system for short, suborbital flights. The company still has to set actual ticket prices or indicate when paid flights could start. New Shepard is designed as a space tourism vehicle that takes paying customers into short-term, multi-minute trips and gives them a brief pause of weightlessness before returning to Earth. Tickets are estimated to cost $200,000. SpaceX. The private space company, founded by billionaire Elon Musk, has signed an agreement with the U.S. space tourism company Space Adventures to launch up to 4 passengers on an orbital trip aboard a Crew Dragon space capsule. The mission would take up to 5 days and could start as early as late 2021. As part of the agreement, Space Adventures will use SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket and a Crew Dragon vehicle to fly up to 4 passengers into orbit. The trip will not visit the International Space Station. Instead, it remains in orbit as a free-flying spaceship. Meanwhile, Space Adventures are also working with Roscosmos to fly 2 space tourists to the International Space Station on a dedicated Soyuz spacecraft in 2021. This gives up to 4 people the opportunity to break the world altitude record for space travel by private individuals and see planet Earth in a new way no one has seen since the Gemini program. SpaceX tourist trips to space station are set to cost $55 million each. Axiom Space signed a contract with Elon Musk's rocket company and could launch tourists into space in 2021. All right, guys, that's the end of this video. Where to buy a ticket round trip to outer space. We hope you really enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. But before you go, share the video, make sure you subscribe to our channel, and don't forget, hit that bell icon to check out more interesting videos made just for you.